Good morning, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. To all my social media friends out there, welcome to Coffee Talk Live. I'm starting a little early here today, and as people begin to come on, we got a hot one. We got Coffee Talk. Welcome to Coffee Talk, and I've got a word that's been percolating me, and I want to thank Andrea from Kentucky. She's on. Dr. Desiree, we're on. Come on, we starting early. These are all the early people who are coming on early. There you go. We've been waiting on this the weekend. We've been waiting on this. Welcome all my friends. Welcome all my family and friends. Make sure you have your coffee. And if you got a honey bun, I wish I had a honey bun cake, Miss Andrea. But if you like for me to promote something that goes with coffee, you know, just tune in. Just send me something and let me taste it, and I will have it with coffee. So if you know how to make coffee cake, if you know how to make honey bun cookies or whatever, make sure you have your coffee ready, and let's have a little something sweet to go along with it. We're going to have a great one here today. Welcome once again. For those who don't know me, I'm Dr. Fariseal, the son of the Miss Tessie Hill legendary artist of the song called He Keeps Doing Great Things For Me. I'm also mentored by the late Dr. Miles Monroe. This is my mentor, the late Dr. Miles Monroe, and he poured into my life for more than 20 years, and he made such a difference in my life. And so it's just great to be with you all here today. It's just great. And I'm telling you what, begin to share this with all your friends. Share this with everybody. Call them on and tell them Dr. Hill is a... We want to welcome also Pakistan, India, Africa, the UK, Jamaica, Kuwait, the Philippines, Zimbabwe, Uganda. We just want to welcome you to Coffee Talk. Welcome around the world. We want to thank you for tuning in with us and connecting with our vision of just helping people around the world. There's nothing like starting your day with a good cup of coffee, a word, music, and motivation. If you start off right, chances are you're going to end up right. We want to thank you. I see someone else coming on. Come on. Yes, thank you. Yes, thank you for coming on. Thank you for coming on. And I'll call your names at the end. Of the show also. But anyway, I do have books. I'm an author of several books right here. These are all of my books right here that I have. And I ask you to get the package deal. Get the books. Come on. We need motivation. Keep the positivity in the atmosphere. You know, there's an acronym for the word atmosphere. Let me give it to you. You can write it down, okay? The word for the different words that I have here for the word atmosphere, the A stands for anticipation. You always get up with anticipation and expectation. The T stands for transformation. Transformation. And I hope as you hear this word today, there'll be transformation. And another word for that T is truth. Another one, of course, is called motivation. That M is for motivation. A is for anticipation. T is for transformation and truth. M is for motivation. O is for opportunity. How many of you looking for opportunity today? I'm looking for opportunity today. I'm telling you, opportunity is waiting on you. I just speak instrumentable favor on you today. Instrumentable favor on you today that it is coming your way. And then also, the S stands for support. The S stands for support. The P stands for provision and prosperity. The H stands for healing. The E stands for encouragement. The R stands for restoration. And the E stands for excellence. Excellence, because he is a God of excellence. So remember, the acronym for atmosphere is A, anticipation, transformation. The T is also for truth. The M is for motivation. The O is for opportunity. The S is for support. The P is provision and prosperity. The H is for healing. The E is for encouragement. The R is for restoration. And the E is what? For excellence. Come on. So today you're going to hear the gift of my motivation. The gift of my motivation today, and I do a lot of inspirational coffee talk. This is our 10th one, but today it's going to be focused on motivation because people need motivation. Now, thank you for coming on, Reginald Hill. Come on, Reginald Leon Hill. Thank you, my brother. Love you, my man. All in Detroit, Michigan. I love you. And so that motivation gift, I'm going to give it to you today. And I know I give a lot of scriptures and on my other coffee talk, but this one I want to just keep it motivational. You know, one of the things that I find that I go riding on my bike every day to work out. I ride my bike. And something that I discovered with my tires is that, you know what? If I keep the air pumped up in those tires, I move faster. If I keep the air pumped up in those tires, then I'm able to move a whole lot faster. And so that's what motivation will do. Motivation will help you move a whole lot faster. And so that's what Dr. Hill wants to do today. He wants to motivate you so you can move a whole lot faster. So let me tell you this, in case no one told you today, you're beautiful, you're lovely, you're needed, you are essential, you are exceptional. You are here for a reason, you're stronger than you think you are. Come on. We're going to get through this pandemic. We're going to get through this pandemic. I'm glad that you are alive. You are here for a purpose. And let me tell you this, don't give up. Don't give up, for the best is yet to come. This is an old school song. An old school song. I got to make the best out of a bad situation. Come on. Yeah. I'm going to talk about controlling the narrative today. Controlling the outcome. Taking a bad situation and turning it into a good situation. You know, there's a phrase that I have that says, when life gives you lemons, you make, in my neighborhood, Kool-Aid. Instead of lemonade, you make Kool-Aid. Come on, Lillian Crawford. Good to see you from California. Good to see you. Come on in. Come on. We're going to go for 15 quick minutes. Come on. If you're there from Africa, if you're there from Kuwait, the Philippines, just chime in. Let me know you're here around the world. Let me know that you are here around the world. Come on. We're going to turn things around. We are going to turn things around. This is your time for your bounce back season. Let me say that again. This is your time for your bounce back season. It's time for you to take control. It's time for you to take control of your own future. So today I want to talk about controlling the narrative. That means you control the outcome. You control the outcome. I said earlier when I did my little commercial of my show today, I had in my hand a remote right here. See this little remote right here? Whoever has the remote controls the channels. You know, in my house, you know, we used to fight for the remote, you know, because we could watch what we wanted to watch. Whoever has the remote, they control the channels. And it's the same way that in your life, whoever controlling your money, your finances, then they're controlling your future. And you don't want that. You don't want that. There's a phrase that I have to say. You are an author and you are an entrepreneur. You're an author and an entrepreneur. You're writing your own story. There's a phrase that I have that says, write your own story and you decide how you want it to be read. And writing your history, make sure no one else is holding the pen. You write your own story. All these books right here, if you want to know about Dr. Hill, these books, it tells everything about me. It tells everything about me. So that way, you know what? One day when I die, nobody's got to lie at my funeral service because I wrote everything down. That's why everybody needs to have a diary. You need to have a diary and begin to write things down, right? You're writing the pages of your life. You are an author and you are what? An entrepreneur. And you're going to decide how you end. You're going to decide whether you win or lose, or your success or your failure. You're an entrepreneur because what? You're the CEO and executive director of a company called You Enterprise. Come on. My mama used to tell me, say, if you don't take care of yourself, you can't expect for nobody else to take care of you. If you don't love you first, you can't love your neighbor if you first don't love you. Come on. This is for somebody. You got to love you. You got to love you despite what things look like, despite what things feel like. You got to love you. You got to see your value. You got to see your worth. You're the CEO of a company called You Enterprise. And if you don't take care of you, you can't expect for nobody else to take care of you. It's called self-preservation. So first thing I want to say is that you want to control the narrative, the outcome, take ownership of your life. Come on. Take ownership of your life. This is your life. If it's to be, it's up to me. It is up to you. You gotta take the remote back. Come on, I'm taking my control back. Come on, come on. I'm taking my future back. I'm not gonna leave my future in somebody else's hand. Not, come on, no one else. I'm not gonna leave it in my boss's hand, my employer, my husband, my wife, my friend, whoever. I'm not gonna, I'm taking my life back. I am taking my life back. Today, this is your wake up call to say, you know what? I'm taking my life back. Everything that belongs to me, I'm taking it back. I'm in control. I may not have it all right now, but you know what? It starts with the mindset. It starts with the mindset. It starts with the mindset. Here in America, and most of us know about the stimulus package. And all of us are, wait, oh, the stimulus package. I say, did you get your stimulus package? This is stimulus package. And for those who are in other countries, that's government assistance. Government assistance. But right now, as most of you know, we're in between the fight between the Republicans and the Democrats and the president, and trying to find out who's going to get it, who's not going to get it. And we're like in the middle. And there's millions of people who are suffering in America, but across the country, because they're dependent on government support. And let me tell you this, there's nothing wrong with government support, but we should never be at a place where we have to depend on government support. We got to go from the stimulus package to the stability package. And the stability package is what you do for you. It's what you create for you. The White House cannot control your house. Come on, that's your house. I'm talking to somebody. You got to decide the outcome of your house for you and your children. So let me tell you this. Don't allow the stimulus package, come on, to become a permanent thing where you sit around and wait around to see if you're going to get a check in the mail. Come on. That's not God's best for you. It's not God's best for you. I had a pastor the other day in another country, and he says, Dr. Hill, we want to start back services and we want to do this, but we can't do anything right now because the government is helping us financially, so they limited us to how many people could come to church, and so we can't do that much. You know what? You got to get out from under that control. Come on, get the remote back. Get the remote back. You control it. Come on. You control your destiny. You control it. Control the narrative. Come on. The energy that you're spending on wondering and worrying about the stimulus package, you can put that energy towards creating your own package. Come on. Begin to create. I release right now creative thinking. I release right now. Come on, witty inventions. I release it right now. Every day when I'm on my bike ride and I'm riding and I'm working out, I'm saying, God, give me creative ideas. Give me money-making ideas. Come on. Money-making ideas. You have it right here. It's right there. Come on. There's other streams that you can be able to create, but you got to take ownership of it. I remember Dr. Miles Monroe, when I would travel with him, and I'd start writing my books and things like that, and Dr. Miles Monroe would tell me, he said, son, own your own publishing company. Get your own publishing company. He says, get your own production company, because whoever has the remote controls you. Reinvent yourself. Come on, invest in yourself. Invest more into yourself, and don't buy into the lie that you're not good enough. Don't buy into the lie that you're not smart enough. Don't buy into the lie that you don't have the ability. Don't buy into the lie that you have messed up so much that you have to depend on somebody else. Come on, I have a song that says it's never too late to start over again. You can start over again. Take the control back. Come on, take the control back. Control. Come on, y'all. Control the narrative. Control. Come on. Control the outcome. Go from stimulus to what? Stability. You can start all over again. How do you know? How do you do that? Number one is know who you are. I'm going to have to continue this next week because I am running out of time. So there'll be a part two because I'm going to talk about controlling the narrative, but I'm also going to be talking about changing the narrative. Change it. Control it and change it. Number one, know who you are. Your identity. See your value. See your value. Come on. See the jewel that's on the inside of you. See the gold that's on the inside of you. Know what you have. See your ability. Come on. See your ability. See who you are. Know what you have and know what you want. Let me say it again. See who you are. Second point is what? Know what you have and know what you want. Your imagination is a preview of what's to come. Your imagination is a preview of what's to come. What do you see for yourself? What do you see for yourself? What do you see for yourself? Stretch yourself. Push yourself. Come on, come on, to the next level. Come on, come on. Don't allow this pandemic to work against you. Come on, but make it work for you. Come on, turn adversity, come on, to your advantage. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Turn crisis into opportunity. You're the next coming attraction. You can never discover who you are trying to be like somebody else, looking at somebody else, or wearing somebody else's brand name. So many of us, the reason why we don't control our destiny, because we're too busy wearing everybody else's name. We're wearing Nike, Gucci, Versace, Jordan, Adidas, Armani, Christian Dior, St. John. We're wearing everybody else. When are you going to wear you? When are you going to wear you? When are you going to, come on, come on, come on, come on. This is for somebody. I'm about to close. Come on. When are you going to wear you? Come on. When are you going to have your own name brand? Come on, come on, come on. Come on. When are you going to build your own brand? You must create your own brand. That means you're going to be different from everybody else. Listen to this phrase right here. God cannot bless who you pretend to be. He cannot bless who you pretend to be. So become the fulfillment of who you are, because everyone else is taken. So step into the real you. Step into the real you. If you want to control the narrative, step into the real you. Embrace who you are. Know who you are, your identity. See your value. Know what you have, your ability. Come on, know what you want. Come on, your destiny. Your destiny, you have it. You have it. You have it. So I believe that we're going from the stimulus package to the stability package. Because I release creative ideas. I release creative ideas. I release creative ideas. I release instrumentable favor. I release it to you. Remember this. Remember this. Today is the beginning of the rest of your life. And it's never too late to turn it around. Today is the beginning of the rest of your life. And once again, I'm here to tell you this. You know what? With God, all things are possible. God, all things are possible. Control the narrative. Another way you can control the narrative, don't stop giving. Don't stop giving. Don't stop sowing. Don't stop. Come on, you see this right here? This is my envelope. I'm ready to go to church, and I'm already prepared in my heart to sow a seed. Come on, because that's how you control the narrative. Come on, come on, come on. Then you get under God's control. He becomes your provider. He becomes your source. And he'll open up a window of heaven and pour out a blessing upon you that you cannot contain. So don't stop sowing. And even if you cannot give finances, you know what you can do? You can give service. You can give service to somebody. Somebody can say, well, I don't have the money, but that's all right. What about donating? No, donating something or donating time to somebody. We are looking now as we prepare to go back on tour. We're looking for people to donate their services, to volunteer. I just had a young lady named Frances, and I don't know if she's on right now, that said, hey, Dr. Hill, you don't have to pay me. Come on, I'll make phone calls for you. I'll do emails for you. Sometimes it's not always money. Sometimes it's just your time. Sometimes it's just your time that you give it. So you want to say, you know, Dr. Hill, I may not be able to financially help you, but you know what I can do? I'll make phone calls for you. I'll do emailing for you. I can give you that time. Come on, just inbox me. Just inbox me. But also, if you say, I want to connect with you, Dr. Hill, I want to be part of your vision, if you like my flow, help me grow, then you know what you can do? Sow a seed. Go Cash App. If you say, you know, this word, controlling the narrative, controlling your outcome, if you say, I want to sow into that, come on, sow. Cash App me right now. Cash App me right now. Cash App me right now. And I'm here to tell you this. If there's a business out there that says, you know what, Dr. Hill, you know what, I like to sponsor Coffee Talk. If you say, I'm a business and I like to sponsor Coffee Talk, I'm looking for somebody saying, I'm going to sponsor you. You need to be on air every Friday. You need to be on air every day. We're playing over and over again, over and over again, because of the different countries and the different times. So you'll see a watch party over and over again. But I encourage you to share with other people. But if you're a company out there, say, you know what, I like what you're doing, I want to sponsor you, I want to sponsor Coffee Talk, inbox me. So I'm looking for some people. Come on, if you say, I'm gonna Cash App you. I'm going to sow a seed. Come on, just send me a word. Send me a word to say, Dr. Hill, I'm one of the 12. At least 12 people to say, I'm going to partnership with you. I'm going to end with this by this song. It's a God in me. Come on, it's a God in me. It's a God in me. Once again, I'm Dr. Ferris Hill. Thank you for all my friends for coming on. Thank you, thank you, thank you. 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 Thank you. Don't forget, get your coffee. And once again, if you want me to help promote your business, or if you know how to make some good cookies, or donuts, or honey buns, Miss Andrea, send it to me. Come on, inbox me, and we'll see what we can do to help promote your business. Remember, he'll give you creative ideas. Creative ideas. I believe it. Make sure you got your coffee. God bless. Thank you for coming on, Dr. Desiree. Thank you, Ms. Lydia. Thank you, Reggie. Thank you. Thank you. If I missed you, I'll catch you. I'll catch you the next time. Hope you share this on a watch party. Controlling the narrative. Taking the remote back. Take it back. Take it back and control the channel of your life. God bless you. I'm Dr. Ferris Hill. Have a great day. Bye-bye. God bless you.